Hey everyone, welcome back. So, the day is finally here. We are going to be putting all the GameCube style controllers head to head, no holds barred, to figure out which are your best options, in my opinion, for playing Super Smash Bros. Ultimate on your Nintendo Switch. So, if you're following my channel, this video has been coming for quite a while. Pretty much each one of these controllers has already received a separate review on my channel. And in each one of those reviews, I mentioned that I'm reviewing this controller as an everyday controller for every game out there. But obviously, for the GameCube style controllers, it's sort of putting them at a disadvantage because they're marketed and they were designed specifically for advantaging one specific game, which is Super Smash Bros. And in each one of those reviews, I pretty much mentioned that at the end, we were going to be doing this roundup to really isolate Super Smash Bros. And figure out what's your best option if you're buying the controller specifically for that one purpose. So in front of me on the table, I have pretty much every officially licensed GameCube style controller offered on the market right now, as well as I threw in one off-branded one just to sort of make a point about those type of controllers when you're trying to buy a Smash Bros. Specific controller. And I also threw in the official Nintendo Switch Pro Controller. And this is going to be sort of like a baseline, indicating to all you out there who might already have a Switch Pro Controller, which controllers I actually think are worth buying specifically for Smash Bros. Above and beyond already having this controller, and which maybe, if you already have a Pro Controller, won't really, in my opinion, offer you anything more other than maybe the nostalgic feel of having a GameCube style controller in your hands. So as we're going through the order of controllers today, don't forget that each one of these controllers has a specific review on my channel. So if ever you're really interested in knowing the other points about any one of these models, you can always check out that review on my channel and get a ton more information than I'm going to give today. I will, however, be pointing out the strong points for playing Smash Bros. And the weaker points for some of these controllers, which is going to be new information that basically weren't in my original reviews. At the same time, just before we get started, I would like to also mention that basically these are my opinions. I'm not a professional Super Smash Bros. Player, I'm just a guy who enjoys the game a ton, which obviously means that you can disagree with me for any of these controllers, and if you do, please leave it down in the comments below and we can have a respectful conversation about it. And to be perfectly honest, and I've actually mentioned it quickly in the reviews of these controllers, pretty much all of these controllers, with maybe one exception, are actually great controllers for playing Super Smash Bros. I just obviously like some more than others, but what's actually separating some of the lower controllers from the ones I prefer and that I'm going to put at the top of my list are actually very, very small points. So basically what I'm saying is we're going to be crowning winners here, but in my opinion, anyone who bought any of these controllers should not feel bad in any way. They will offer you really great gaming experiences. Now, just before we get the list started, don't forget that if you do like this video, please drop a like on it. And if you aren't subscribed to the channel but would like to see more content, don't forget to hit that subscribe button before the end. So now we're going to get started. Basically, I'm going to be clearing the table, and what I'm going to be doing is bringing up the controllers from my least favorite to favorite on this end. And basically, as I bring the controllers up, I'm going to be mentioning exactly what the points are that place the controller where it is on my list. So first, and also unfortunately meaning it's the lowest positioned controller on the list today, is the KinGear Nintendo Switch Pro Controller. And this is sort of a placeholder for all those off-branded, uber-cheap GameCube-style controllers. And some of them have odd twists just like this one, where it's basically shaped like an Xbox One controller, but has a GameCube basic button layout. And I would say all these controllers share a lot of things in common. And the number one problem is that the quality is lower. And if you're looking for a specific controller for Smash Bros., because like I said, today's video is just Smash Bros., because this could be a decent option for a really cheap second player controller for all around gaming, just because of the insanely low price and the features it offers. However, if we're talking about upping your game in Super Smash Bros., this controller is not the way to go, and I would say that all those uber cheap off-branded controllers aren't the way to go. And the main reason is that some of the other controllers that are going to come up here in a couple of minutes start at as low as like $20 and sometimes go on sale for as low as $15. And trust me, if you want to up your game in Super Smash Bros., that extra $5 is going to go a long way. So unfortunately, if you're looking at a specific controller for Super Smash Bros. And you're looking at those off-branded, uber cheap, some are even exact copies of GameCube controllers, I'm telling you right now, it's probably not the way to go because the button quality is low, the joystick quality is lower, and it's just not going to up your game. If you have any style of regular pro controller from an officially licensed brand, I would say you're going to be better sticking with that controller than switching to one of those cheaper ones. Now, just before we move on to the next controller, I forgot to mention that if you guys want to pick up any of these controllers, I'm going to be leaving affiliate links in the description of the video down below. So feel free to use those links. It helps the channel out a little bit. Now, the next entry on the list, I might be getting a little heat from some people out there on, but I have to go with my gut, and that is the official GameCube controller from back in the day, with the help of an adapter. Now, first and foremost, this isn't the only adapter out there. I'm showing you the 8-bit though one here, just for reference sake. But basically, if you want to use a controller like this on your Nintendo Switch, you're going to need some form of adapter to have it sync up. One of the reasons I really like the 8-bit though one is that it actually makes your controller wireless, because this little thing actually connects to your Switch wirelessly. You plug your controller into it and it basically turns your GameCube controller into a semi-wireless controller. It'll still have to be plugged into this, but you can carry this around the room wherever you want. And that gets me to one of the reasons I actually don't appreciate this controller too much nowadays for playing Super Smash Bros. The old school cable is actually quite short compared to controllers nowadays, meaning that if you don't have an extension around, that 8-bit DOE is a decent option, but at the same time, any form of adapter is always going to put a little bit of lag in your game. And I'm not talking about lagging the Switch, I'm talking about input lag. It's not huge, it's not game-breaking, but I do feel it there from time to time. And unfortunately, even the wired adapters I find are not lagless. There is sort of a delay where you can see that the Switch is actually converting the inputs into traditional Switch inputs. And also, I really don't like the feel of the analog triggers on the GameCube when they're actually useless. In the sense that, if you don't know, the Switch doesn't recognize analog inputs. They're all digital switches now. So the fact that the GameCube in the back has such a long travel time on the Switches is sort of a waste. Now, I know that there's a lot of purists out there that think that this is the perfect way to play because it's the original controller, but I personally find that nowadays, with the controllers that have come out, there are actually better options out there. And that's why it's actually on the lower end of my list. So please, don't hate me too much. Now, the next controller on my list looks like a carbon copy of the last one, but this is the PowerA wired GameCube style controller. Now, I just want to be precise. We are, for the moment, speaking only about the wired version because the wireless one is coming up later and it is not positioned the same as this one. Now, the reason this controller is where it is on the list is some of the same points we just discussed in the classic GameCube style controller. This controller really isn't offering you anything new for today's standards. It's almost a carbon copy of the previous controller, only offering you a slightly larger D-pad, which isn't really much use in Super Smash Bros. And one of the major points that I didn't like about this controller is that they copied the GameCube style controller, the original one, down to a fault. A fault meaning that they actually copied the feel of those analog triggers in the back, meaning that the buttons have really long travel times, but they're actually digital. Basically, the controller does nothing for, you know, 90% of the back button travel time, and everything done is done in that last tiny little press at the end. PowerA also didn't sort of improve on the design comfort-wise at all. I mean, the controller feels okay in hand, but because of the other controllers on the list, it doesn't feel the greatest. And I find that the plastic used and the button feel is not one of the best among the controllers we're going to look at today. However, what does make it edge out the original GameCube controller is that it does come with that 10-foot cable, meaning that you won't need extenders generally for, most gameplay setups. And secondly, it's just so much more cost efficient, meaning that the controller is going to cost you generally around $25, and you don't have to have any type of adapter or, buy anything else aside with it. And just remember, before we move on to the next controller, as I said when I started this list, everything except for maybe the low-end controller here are still incredibly decent options for playing Super Smash Bros. We're just looking today for which ones are offering the best options. So now we get to the next controller on the list, and this is where I'm going to be placing the classic Nintendo Switch Pro Controller. Now, honestly, I don't think there's much I can say about this controller that hasn't already been said. It's just an all-around fantastic controller. It offers incredible build quality, it offers incredibly good gameplay, and that's why I'm actually placing it where it is on the list. It's not even the lowest controller for playing Super Smash Bros. In my opinion, if you own this controller, you actually probably aren't going to gain much from going with any of these other controllers here. And you will be gaining, like I said, in Super Smash Bros. With some of the higher controllers, but you don't need to feel bad if you're playing with the original Pro Controller. And feature-wise, this controller is just so rich. You can read your amiibos without getting up from your seat. You have that incredible haptic feedback that has put Nintendo on the map. And comfort-wise, although I wish the controller was a little bit bigger because with my hands it does feel a little bit on the smaller side, it is, in my opinion, one very decent option for playing Super Smash Bros. So I'm not going to spend too much time on this controller because I want the GameCube style controllers to be the star of this video. But like I said, from now on out, all the controllers that are going to be on the list, I would place above the official Nintendo Switch Pro Controller, meaning that they will probably enhance your Super Smash Bros. Gameplay. So next, we get to the Hori Battle Pad. Now, don't be mistaken, this controller is offered in a lot of visual varieties. The reason why I have the Peach version is because I bought this controller mainly for my 7-year-old daughter, who's a huge Super Smash Bros. Fan as well. And obviously, when I asked her to choose a controller, what did you think? She went with the pink one. Now, I actually really enjoy playing with this controller. This controller has a really nice finish to it, and it feels actually really good in your hand. The only thing I wished is that, once again, it was built a little bit more on the larger side. However, if you have smaller hands or you're buying this controller for a child, this is one great controller for that purpose. So what sets it apart from the controllers that have been on the list so far is, like I said, that textured material really adds a really good grip on the controller for longer play sessions. And it has everything you could ask for from a GameCube style controller. It has the proper button layout with nice spaced buttons. For me, it has those clicky digital triggers on all four top buttons. It has notched joysticks and C-stick. And what allows it to set it a little bit above the other controllers is that it's finally offering something new that isn't even available on the Pro Controller, and that is turbo functionality. Now, once again, I know for some purists out there, you're going to be like, using turbo is cheating. But for the common player out there or someone who just plays casually, having the turbo functionality is really going to help them in some aspects of the game. And when you're playing with players of hugely different age groups, it might actually help that younger player to have that little bit of an advantage that'll help him compete with his older, siblings. This controller isn't very expensive as well. Once again, you can generally pick it up around $25. Sometimes it's on sale at $20. Sometimes it goes for a little more for the models that are in more high demand. But overall, this is the first controller, in my opinion, that if you're looking to enhance your experience in Super Smash Bros. And you already own a Pro Controller, this is one of the decent investments. So now we only have two controllers left on the list, and coming in second place would be the Power A wireless GameCube style controller. Now, when I said earlier that I was speaking specifically about the wired version, that was because of this controller, because Power A is one of the only non-official companies to make a wireless edition of the GameCube style controller. And I would say that that is one of the main reasons that's setting it so high on the list. The fact to have a wireless controller can be a huge advantage for a lot of people out there. And for me, it even sets it higher than the Hori Battle Pad that has a turbo functionality. Because for an all-around player, I would say that having a wireless controller is a more useful advantage than turbo that only certain players will want to take advantage of. Also, this controller pretty much fixes the two main issues I had with the wired version of the controller. Number one, the plastic used is of higher quality. You can tell that the control is much sturdier and actually feels more comfortable in your hand. And secondly, they did away with those horrible fake analog triggers, and you have really responsive digital shoulder buttons. And actually, I would go as far to say that of all the shoulder buttons on this table, these are the best feeling shoulder buttons overall. They are not my favorite controller overall, that's going to be the next one, but the shoulder buttons on this one actually feel amazing. And if you watch my review on this controller, that's why I say that this is actually a contender for a really decent all-around controller if you get used to your GameCube layout. But that's not what we're talking about today. We're talking about Super Smash Bros., and if you buy this controller, you will not be disappointed, and the advantages it's offering are really going to set it apart for you when you play that game. However, there is one important issue you need to know about this controller, and that's the fact that it does not have a rechargeable battery. It requires double A's. And for the hefty price tag that this controller goes for, which is almost $50, I really wish they would have included that rechargeable battery. It would have made it a lot easier sell for a lot of people out there. However, if I'm honest with you guys, it's not a crushing issue for me. I actually prefer swapping out a couple of double A's than waiting for my controller to recharge before I'm able to play with it wirelessly once again. And if you use rechargeable batteries, like I said, it really becomes a non-issue. But at the same time, for any of you out there that really want the information, it's something that's really important to know about this controller. And now we come to it, the top controller on my list, which is the PDP Fight Pad Pro. Now, as the last two controllers, this controller also comes in quite a variety of colors and designs. Actually, for the GameCube style controllers, this is pretty much the controller that comes in the most types of variations. So whether you like Mario, whether you like Link, whether you like even Sonic the Hedgehog, there's a PDP wired Fight Pad Pro out there for you. But the aesthetic design isn't what's putting it at the top of my list. What's really putting this controller at the top of my list, in my opinion, is the incredible feel that this controller is offering. Now, out of all the controllers here on the table, this is the controller with the largest build. So if you have larger hands, I'm telling you right away, this is most likely the controller that is going to feel most comfortable in your hands. The texture of the plastic, which feels almost slightly rubberized, is also actually really, really good for long play sessions. I would say it's only rivaled with the texture on the Hori Fight Pad. Also, the design of the extra large bumpers here at the back is actually really helpful for someone who's actually just starting out in Smash Brothers. Although they aren't my overall favorite feeling bumpers, as I said on the previous controller, they are a very close second, and combined with all the other features so far, is one of the reasons why this controller is coming out as the top controller, in my opinion. And lastly, the biggest feature, and what I love probably most about this controller, is the versatility it offers for different people. The reason why is because this controller has one last hidden feature about it. And that last feature is the actual swappable joystick here from a C-stick to a traditional thumbstick. And although you might be telling me, why are you talking about putting a traditional thumbstick when we're talking about GameCube style controllers? It's just a question of adaptability to different play styles. What I love about the PDP design is that they don't box you in. If your play style, you prefer a traditional thumbstick rather than having the C-stick, well, you have that option on this controller, meaning that you can take the pleasure from the overall GameCube design, but have the substitute for that C-stick. And at the same time, if you're a purist, well, you're not losing anything out. You swap that out, you put your C-stick nub on there, and everything feels just perfect and classic. Now, if there's maybe one thing I could say about this controller that I wish they would have, changed for Super Smash Bros., is I would have loved for them to throw in either a turbo functionality or offer a wireless design. Had they done that, I would just say that it would probably be the undisputed top controller for probably everyone out there. But even without those features, for me, it's my top pick. If you're looking for a controller that's going to enhance your Super Smash Bros. Experience, I think that the PDP Wired Fight Pad Pro is probably the way to go. And the cherry on top compared to, let's say, the PowerA, is that the price tag on this controller is once again only about $25. So if you have a big household or you just invite friends over often, you can actually buy two of these controllers for one of these. Anyway, I think I've said enough. If you want any more information, you can go check out the review on the PDP Fight Pad Pro on my channel. I go really into details with a lot of close-ups on this controller as well as all the others here. So now here we are. Now, like I said at the beginning, this video was a long time coming, and now we have it right in front of us. My picks for top Smash Brothers controller, from my favorite controller to my least favorite. Now, I've said it already, but I really can't say it enough. Don't forget that, in my opinion, except for, like I said, maybe the cheapest controller on this list, all of these are excellent options for playing Super Smash Bros. And ultimately, I've given you my reasons why each controller is where it is, and I have the advantage to have played with all of them, which I know that a lot of you out there unfortunately don't have the option to do. But then again, that's why I do these videos, to give you guys the reasons why the controllers are more liked or more disliked, in my opinion. And at the same time, if any of you disagree out there, some of the points for these controllers, as I said, could maybe be totally opposite for you. But then again, I guess that's why we do these videos, to basically give you the points of why the controllers are better for certain people and less for others. And although my top controller came as the PDP controller, if you have smaller hands, for you it could possibly be the Hori Fight Pad. So as I said at the beginning of the video, if you disagree or you want to maybe point out anything that I might have missed in this video, feel free to leave it down in the comments and we'll have a really nice discussion about it. Now, just a quick reminder before we go. Like I said, I'm leaving affiliate links for all these controllers, so feel free to check them out down below in the description of the video. But I'm not sponsored in any way, so I'm not paid by any of these companies for this review. And if you've gotten to this point in the video, well, don't forget to smash that like button, subscribe if you aren't already, and activate the notification bell so that you know when all my new videos come out. Now, this roundup was a heck of a lot of fun for me, so I hope you guys really liked it as well. And as usual, I hope I'll see you all in my next video.